Okay, so for our parkour intermediate class, we're gonna be practicing and learning the backwards roll. So just like your forward roll, you're rolling from your shoulders to your hip. And so a great way to practice this is if you have your forward roll down, you'll roll across to that sitting position. And then exactly the same in reverse, everything's the same. You wanna tuck your head in to the opposite shoulder. So if I'm rolling over my right shoulder, like I'm on the phone, I'm gonna tuck my head to my left shoulder, just like the normal roll. And just like the normal roll, I'm gonna be rolling across my arm. Your forearm is what's gonna be contacting and keeping your head away from the ground. So I'll roll over, and that's gonna keep me away. So a great way to practice this is just rolling back and forth through your front and side roll, making sure your feet are really nice and tight. This comes in handy if I'm dropping from something and I land and I fall back, I can roll right out of it. And so just practicing first from the sitting position, back and forth, then eventually from standing, falling back. Sit and fall back. Making sure to keep your head tucked to the side, rolling shoulder to hip. And eventually you can start doing jumps, down, up and over. Always making sure to keep the weight on your forearm and shoulder and keeping your head to the opposite side. Practice both sides. You'll never know which way you'll have to roll, and that's the backwards roll. All right, another great review for our parkour class is the speed vault. This is one of the most basic vaults. It's to make sure exactly what it says, that you keep your speed. The main thing of a speed vault is keeping one hand on and getting your body completely horizontal. The best way to do this is when you come, you'll kick one foot up. And that will pull your other foot up, like you're trying to keep your ankles together. Tapping your hand on, kicking that foot up, and over. So as you get closer and closer, each time, throwing that foot, bringing your heels together, and over. So when you do it nice and fast, you'll come up, hand down, kick, feet together. And as you practice that, make sure to keep those feet together, straight, bent, doesn't matter. Make sure you're nice and horizontal. And you can do the speed. So this is called the speed or the one-handed vault. All right, the next review that we're gonna do for our parkour class is the dash. The first thing you need to be able to do for dash is you need to be able to get your feet up straight, nice and hip level. If you need to sit down, do toe touches, kicks, you gotta be able to get your feet up. Try and kick one foot up. Try the other one, kick one foot up. And eventually, both feet together. And that's a pike jump. And so when you're getting ready to dash, you're gonna come at your surface and you're gonna pike jump. It's all about throwing that one knee and bringing your other foot up to match it. When you come to the dash, now it's just putting your hands down. So you'll come at it, kick over, and you'll touch those hands behind you. Taking a little bit of the weight, taking a little bit of the momentum, getting you perfectly into your dash. Now we're gonna learn the flip. This is something we've learned in our parkour class, and we call it a haro or the side flip. The way to practice and start learning this is doing what we call a shoulder roll. It's over an object, I'm gonna roll right over the tops of my shoulder blades. I'm trying to keep my feet up. It'll be tucking my shoulder in and my hands in and kicking one foot out. And that'll give me my shoulder roll to be up and over. The more you rely on the object to learn, it's not bad. And then, as you start going forward and forward, trying to do that flip, you want to try, use your imagination, imagine the object a little bit higher. Try not to become dependent on your obstacle. Imagine it's a little bit higher, same kind of motion. That shoulder roll, throwing that foot, just like you're rolling over a higher object that isn't there. Doing that, you can learn the haro and side flip. Another great vault for us to practice is the back vault. It's something we've learned a little bit about, and it's coming, and just like you throw with your shoulder to do the side flip, usually you'll do the same side. For me, that's my right side. So I'll come, and I'll plant my right hand, and I'm gonna throw my shoulder and kick my foot up behind me. It can either be straight or tucked. And as I throw it over, I'm gonna try to get my hand as straight as possible. So when I come at it, I'll hit. And it's really throwing your shoulder and your knee. I keep my knee tucked. So a great way to practice this is same way with the side roll, the side flip, learning to to do that shoulder roll. Figure out which side's comfortable. And generally, it'll be the same side for when you do the back vault. Making sure to throw that shoulder and that knee to really give you that rotation and that jump for the back vault.